like to talk about energy expenditure calculations of Bronze Age metalworking technology. And this talk is based on my master thesis, which was submitted to the university in 2016 and will be published in the German series Archäologische Berichte. So, in Central European Bronze Age, a major transformation process in metalworking technology is evident. And I will show that the observed changes are also visible in the energy expenditure invested in Bronze Age metallurgy. At first, I would like to explain some basic concepts of my work. The energy expenditure characterizes the expenditure used for an activity, for example, the building of a house. It is measured in person hours. One person hour corresponds to the work one person can provide in 1 hour. And it is also referred to as energy, as expenditure of time, amount of work, effort, labor cost, or labor input. The next terms I like to discuss are labor and value. My work is based on the assumption that the invested labor reflects the so-called natural price within classical economics, which results from the sum of expenses used for the production and distribution. Karl Marx describes a similar concept, which he calls exchange value. So when I talk about the calculation of energy expenditure, these are the underlying concepts. A totally different question is whether in prehistory the value of objects is also expressed in the labor invested for their production. This cannot be answered using archaeological methods. My working area encompasses central and southern Germany, as well as parts of the Austrian, Swiss, and Italian Alps, where archaeological evidence for primary and secondary metallurgy exists. My working period is the Central European Bronze Age between 2200 and 800 BC. On the map, selected mining sites are indicated, which will be considered later in my talk. So the following remarks refer to the working area only, unless stated otherwise. Before I get to the energy expenditure calculations, I briefly would like to summarize the production steps of Bronze Age metallurgy, because it's important for further understanding. My energy expenditure calculations include only those parts of the production sequence with direct archaeological evidence. These are mining activities, ore beneficiation, smelting, alloying, casting, and post-processing. Looking at the archaeological evidence for Bronze Age metallurgy, some differences between the early Bronze Age in contrast to the middle and late Bronze Age can be observed around 1800 BC, mainly in the smelting and alloying process. This is important because it is greatly reflected in the energy expenditure and demand for wood. I presume in my calculation that during the early Bronze Age, copper was produced in hearth pits using oxidizing smelting techniques, as indicated by features from the Trentino. And in the middle and late Bronze Age, in smelting facilities with shaft furnaces and roasting beds, using reducing techniques as indicated by features from the Eastern Alps. The alloying process changes at the end of the early Bronze Age, when copper and arsenic copper are replaced by tin bronze. Next, I would like to explain how I conducted my calculations, and as the basis for my work, I studied the archaeological evidence in the working area to reconstruct the production steps of the metalworking process, which I just showed you. And so how do we calculate the energy expenditure for a 4,000-year-old process for which no written record exists? I did it with the help of experimental archaeology. And for this, I collected information about the energy expenditure from about 80 scientific publications of archaeological experiments. I collected the time data and the weight of the used resources, ore and copper and wood in kilograms. to make the data from different experiments comparable, the time data were put into relation with the weight of the required resources. This means so and so much kilograms wood is required to smelt so and so much kilograms copper ore. In addition, a copper slash ore wood ratio for every production step or technique was determined. For example, 1-to-2 or 1-to-1 ratio. This makes it possible to calculate the demand for wood from the ratio copper ore to wood. And charcoal findings from different sites indicate that wood and not charcoal was used in most production steps. In this manner, it is possible to calculate the energy expenditure and demand for wood for each production step. At this point, I decided to implement the ore-wood ratio of the different production steps into a Microsoft Excel sheet to speed up the calculation process and to enable the testing by means of examples. I used the weight of the artifacts as an indicator for the required amount of raw material, and in this manner I am able to calculate the energy expenditure and demand for wood for any copper or bronze object whose weight is documented. Thus, it is likewise possible to calculate the energy expenditure and demand for wood for artifacts from one specific context, for example, for a hoard inventory. And it is also possible to use the estimations of copper output from different mining sites to calculate the demand for wood for the artifacts from specific mining sites, what I will explain in detail in a moment. On this side, you see the main results of my calculations for Bronze Age metallurgy in a diachronic perspective. I used the production of 100 ETSs as an example. With the ETS in artifact category was chosen that was available throughout the Bronze Age in different types. And 200 grams was chosen as an average weight for the artifact category ETS. The energy expenditure is given in person hours, short pH, and the demand for wood is given in kilograms. And in cases where the demand for wood is not specified, no information was available. So to conclude, as you can see here, the production of 100 copper ETSs using early Bronze Age production techniques needs about 4,600 person hours or 46 person hours for one copper ETS in the early Bronze Age. The production of 100 tin bronze ETSs using middle and late Bronze Age technology needs about 3,600 person hours or 36 person hours for one tin bronze ETS in the middle and late Bronze Age. This difference can mainly be ascribed to the less effective oxidizing smelting process used in the early Bronze Age, which is indicated here. The energy expenditure for the production of tin is assumed to be 1/10 of the expenditure for copper, assuming the tin bronzes contain 10% of zinc, which you can see here. Wood is required as a fuel mainly for the mining activities, the smelting process, casting and post-processing. The demand for wood is calculated from the ore-wood ratio, as I explained on the former slide. The results show that in the early Bronze Age production process, that the early Bronze Age production process needs about 116 kilograms of wood to produce one copper ETS, while the middle or late Bronze Age production process needs only 90 kilograms of wood to produce one tin bronze ETS. This indicates that the later process is more effective in terms of resource consumption because the reducing smelting process has a lower demand for wood. Hence, with the end of the early Bronze Age, at around 1600 BC, we can see a transformation in metalworking technology, which is reflected in the energy expenditure and the demand for wood. As mentioned earlier, it is possible to use the estimations of copper output from different mining sites. Therefore, I have selected some mining sites for which estimations of the copper output were available. because only few estimations of copper output are available from the working area. Sites from neighboring European regions were also included. This chronological scheme shows the dating of the selected mining sites. The sites concerned here are Saint-Véran in France, Mount Gabriel in Ireland, the Mitterberg region in Austria, and Ivona in Bulgaria. Most of them fall into the time frame of the Central European Bronze Age, with the exception of Ivona. On this slide, you see a graphic representation of my approach and an example below. The example used here is the Mitterberg main lode in Austria. So this site is dated to the period 1600 to 900 BC. It has therefore a period of use of 700 years. According to Eitner, the total copper output from the Mitterberg main lode was 10,000 tons. The average copper output per year would therefore be 14 tons. If we assume that one artifact has a weight of 200 grams, this would result in 70,000 artifacts, possibly produced per year. So the demand for wood for the production of these artifacts calculated from the ore-wood ratio would thereby be around 7,000 tons per year. Let's have a closer look on the number of potentially produced artifacts and their demand for wood. This diagram shows the number of artifacts which could have been produced from the copper of the selected mining sites in 1 year. Although no clear chronological lines can be drawn, there's a tendency to say that the earlier sites used here as a comparison produce less copper and therefore artifacts than the Mitterberg main lode, with Saint-Véran, for example, producing 17,500 artifacts per year and the Mitterberg main lode producing copper for 70,000 artifacts per year. In the demand for wood, similar tendencies can be observed. The demand grows with the number of produced artifacts. We can see the production of the artifacts. We can see that the production of the artifacts from Saint-Véran requires about 2,000 tons of wood, while the production of the artifacts from the Mitterberg main lode requires about 7,000 tons of wood per year. To conclude, I was able to show you that around 1600 BC, transformation in metalworking technology is visible, which is reflected in the energy expenditure and the demand for wood. I showed that it is possible to compare the energy expenditure for different production steps of Bronze Age metallurgy. The required energy expenditure and demand for wood decreases with the change in smelting technology at around 1600 BC. This means that the production process gets more effective and allows for the production of larger amounts of metals with a lower investment of resources. In turn, we know from the archaeological record that from the beginning of the Middle Bronze Age onwards, the mining activities and the copper output increased significantly in the working area. This resulted in an increasing total energy expenditure and demand for wood in the Middle and Late Bronze Age. Altogether, the named factors point towards a major transformation in Bronze Age metalworking technology at the end of the Early Bronze Age, around 1600 BC.